We see them, starting with Mr. Lynn Kuhn, the senior. Please come up, Mr. Kuhn, and for the record, state your address.
My address, I live at 1150 North Willow, across from Idaho High School. Madam Mayor, distinguished councilmen, community. I'm here really to draw attention to our complex. I've been there for maybe 25 years, and it's been like a marked increase in criminal activity, crime, shooting. Originally, it was a gated community, but the gate hasn't worked in the last 20 years. So that leaves the door open for anyone who wants to come into our community to sell drugs, peddle drugs. And we have open gambling, a lot of times the kids from Eisenhower, they'll come there as a haven. They can hide there. There's over 100 units there. And so they can hide and just, miss school there. And it's getting increasingly violent. Just past Sunday, a young man lost his life, and two other young men were shot. And I think my primary concern is for, the community at large, but the children. There's a lot of children in the community. And at the time of the shooting, at 8 o'clock Sunday evening, or approximately 8 o'clock Sunday evening, they were having, they had the big tents, the jumpers for the kids. They had one in the front and the back, and they had just kind of taken that down before that happened. And there was gambling here on the site. But something has to be done. I think we need security, and those gates need to work, and we need to have some way to monitor who comes in and out, because, it's wide open. People say, well, I can go there and I can make a living there. I can make my little hustle there, the infamous ABCs. So I'm just hoping that, the words don't fall on deaf ears, and something can be done before any more loss of life. Because a month and a half ago, a young man was killed in the same, not killed, but shot, several times in the same apartment complex. The year before that, the man was killed and laid out there for like 12 hours and, all night, really. And 4 years ago, like 7 people were shot. There's, drug activity involved, but 7 people were shot, in that particular complex. It's too easy. It's too accessible for anyone who feel they want to come in and do whatever they really want to do. And that's all I really have to say, Madam Mayor, and I thank you for your time.
Thank you, Mr. Burke. And I believe we have a few others who also have asked to speak, y'all are addressing the same matter, but I was going to ask the police chief if he would like to make a comment, and I would like to say personally to you and the community that it really was unfortunate that someone had to lose their life, and that was one of my immediate concerns to the chief was the fact that there had been a children's party, and it could have been far worse than that, but I would like our chief to speak to it, because I know that they've been addressing it, and then I don't know the actual who owns the apartment complex, but I'm sure that we can work with the property owner to address some of the concerns that the residents seem to be bringing to our attention.
Well, I certainly echo the comments from the gentleman that was up and the council's concern as well. We will take some drastic measures at that complex. We'll work with the apartment owners, we know who the owners are, to see that they can get the facilities and the grounds fixed, especially the gates, and to address some of the other concerns. And we already have a mechanism in place that we're working on with our gang unit to try to deal with some of the issues that are taking place up there. So after the council meeting, I'd be more than happy to meet with some of the folks in the back and talk to them about some of the things that we have, that I can tell them that we have planned to deal with some of the issues that are happening up there.
Okay, good. And yes, okay, Mayor Pro Tem. And for those of you in the audience too, there's a special relationship that I've
discuss with you later, but I can meet with the chief and you after the meeting, that's it.
And I know that others did fill out their papers and someone else was before you, but I would ask the representative from the Congress member, if he doesn't mind, if he could give these other two an opportunity to speak because it's on the same subject, and then I'm happy to hear from the Congress member. Mrs. Sharika Smith, if you'd like to come forward. And again, state your name and address as well.
Good evening, Madam Mayor and council members. My name is Sharika Smith. I'm a resident at 1150 North Willow Avenue, located in Yalta. My issue at hand is also with the safety of our residents in that community alone. I've been there for 12 years now. I am a victim of a crime myself, so me getting over, not even getting over, but trying to overcome the impact that has messed up my life and the life of my children, I finally, you know, got out this past Sunday, and to have my kids encounter that shooting to death, and it's just, it brings me back into that same shell. So I'm here tonight because I want to see a change. I want to see a difference. I've been there, like I said, 12 years now, and the gates never worked since I've been there. The activities that are going on inside this complex is not with the residents. We are more of a family-oriented complex. The people that does not live there are the ones who are coming in with the gang activities. They're the ones who are selling drugs amongst our children. And I just want to see something different. Because my kids are there and I'm there and other kids are there. And if it's hard for me, it's even harder on the child. And it's just emotionally distressing for them and as well as myself. And I'm not in a predicament to just get up and just leave.
Right.
So I think something needs to be done because the things that I'm trying to keep my kids away from is actually right in front of. It's like I can't, it exists, it's out there in the world, but when you actually go out and you can see it happening outside your door, it's something totally different. So it's not like I can just turn off the TV, because when you walk outside your door, it's right there, and you know, it's horrible, it's very horrible. So as a community, as a rural village resident, whatever I can do to pitch in or, you know, to do the neighborhood watching or whatever it is, just let me know, because my kids' safety comes first, and right now they're not safe. And me as a parent, I feel that I am not doing my job as a parent because I cannot remove them from this situation, and it's hard. So, yeah, I just very much concerned about the safety and getting the gates up and working so they could monitor who comes in and who goes out.
Okay. Yes. Thank you, Ms. Smith.
Okay, thank you.
Appreciate you coming through. And the other person, Sharon Bilbray? Bilbray, did I pronounce it correct? Ms. Bilbray?
Hello, my name is Sharon Rose Bilbray. I'm a resident of 1150 North Willow of Rialto. We, the residents at Willow Village, located at 1150 North Willow Avenue, we are in need of insurance. We feel our safety is in danger, and we are requesting armed security at our property. The police, Rialto police, have proven that our community safety is no longer their priorities. The residents are not the problem. The trespassers are. We believe that our family deserves the feeling of safe security. Children in our community are no longer safe playing outside because of these intruders that have no appreciation with the residents. Please help our community feel safe again as we submit this petition and agreements to feel safe at our home. And I wanted to say that I see that y'all have bridge to progress. And in our apartments, we can have progress over here on those gates to keep them as safe for our children and for we live. When we lay out here, I know we're each and every one of y'all, but y'all live, I know y'all safe. Y'all got it good, but what about us, the people that's at the lower, at the bottom? We want to reach to the top, just like everybody else. We want to become one, and we want the safety here. So we won't have to go through this. We don't deserve this. We deserve that our children grow up and be conquered and have success and be properties. know, just think about the children and about the residents so we can feel safe again. Thank you and God bless.
Thank you. Well, and as we said, if you can wait until the conclusion of the meeting, the police chief will meet with you also, and also probably mention neighborhood watch coordinators. We are willing to look at that. And I know we have our neighborhood watch coordinator here in the audience as well. So thank you again for coming out and expressing your concerns. The next person that would come forward, and again, I appreciate the willingness to wait, Gregory Young, representative for Congress member Gary Miller's office. Good evening.
Yeah, well, good evening, Madam Mayor, members of the council.